Okay, so we're now going to learn how to solve systems of linear equations using a process called Gaussian elimination. Okay, Gauss, by the way, one of the great geniuses of mathematics. His name pops up all over the place, Gaussians and so on. And he invented Gaussian elimination hundreds of years ago. So suppose someone gives you a system of equations to solve, like a bunch of variables, x1 up to xn, and a bunch of equations, m equations in these variables. And you have to solve these equations. As an example, someone gives you four equations here in these three variables and asks you to solve these to find a solution. What does finding a solution mean? It means finding values x1, x2 up till xn, which satisfy the system of equations. A couple of definitions. If all the right-hand side, if all the constant terms are zero, then it's called a homogeneous system of equations. If at least one is non-zero, then it's called a non-homogeneous system, okay? And a little bit of thought tells you if the system is homogeneous, then there's always at least the trivial solution, all zero solution. Like if the right-hand sides are all zero, then clearly, if I put x1 is 0, x2 is 0, all the way till xn is 0, then both sides are 0, right? The left-hand side of each of the equations is 0, the right-hand side is 0. So clearly, this 0 is a trivial solution. But there may be other non-trivial solutions as well. Anyway, so we'll be interested in solving homogeneous and non-homogeneous solutions, both homogeneous and non-homogeneous system equations. So first of all, how does one solve a system of equations? So let's do an example first. So there are these four equations, and you have to try to find solutions to values for x1, x2, x3 that simultaneously satisfy each of these four equations. So when you're doing Gaussian elimination, the first step is to choose a pivot equation. So in this case, we'll choose a pivot equation, which is the first one. What's a pivot equation? Something that involves the first variable that you want to find the value of. So in this case, we're choosing x1 to be the pivot. And using this, we try to eliminate x1 from each of the other equations. So how do we do that? So for example, we can do equation 2 plus equation 1. Because equation 2 has a minus x1, equation 1 has an x1. So if we add these two equations together, we'll end up with, well, 0 is equal to 0 in this case. And if we do equation 4 minus 20 times equation 1, equation 4 has 20x1, equation 1 has x1. So if we subtract 20 times this equation from this equation, then clearly you'll have gotten rid of the x1, right? And you'll be left with, when you do the calculation, you'll be left with 30x2 plus 20x3. The third equation, we didn't need to do anything. It didn't have an x1 in it anyway. Okay, so now you have this system of equations. Now you can change the order of the equations if needed and do the same with x2. So now you choose x2 to be a pivot and now eliminate this guy over here. So once you do this, then you end up with a system of equations that looks like a triangular system of equations, right? And there's a connection with upper triangular matrices, which we'll see later. So anyway, here now you have the first equation has x1, x2, x3, all three in it. The second equation has just x2, x3. The last one has just x3. And the fourth one is sort of a trivial equation. It doesn't matter. Now we do back substitution. So in reverse order, we try to figure out x3, x2, x1. So the last equation already allows us to compute x3, right? Because there's only x3 in it. So we can compute x3 is 2. Now, once we know x3, we can substitute. Once we have computed x3 is 2, we can substitute its value as 2 over here. So this becomes 25 times 2. This is just 2, right? So therefore, we then have this equation then becomes 10x2 plus 50 is equal to 90. So therefore, when you solve, you get x2 is equal to 4, right? And now you know that x2 is 4, x3 is 2. Therefore, when you solve, therefore you get x1 is 2. So that's why this is called back substitution, because we keep substituting back the variables that we found the values of. And at each step, you just need to find one new variable here. Okay? So this is the way of doing of solving systems of equations. But the question is, can we do this in a more systematic manner using perhaps matrices and not equations? And the answer is yes, using the process of Gaussian elimination. So what do? We we write it, we write a matrix equation like this. And what is this? So the coefficients here are basically the coefficients of the equations. So these equations over here, I just write this system of equations as a11, a12, up till a1n, am1 up till amn, times the vector x1 up till xn is equal to b1 up to bn. And if you do this matrix quantification, you can see that the left hand side is basically like the first term in this matrix quantification is indeed a11 x1 plus a12 x2 over to a1 and xn, right? And the right hand side is indeed b1. Similarly, the second term in this matrix quantification, this times this, is indeed a21 x1 up to a2n xn. The right hand side is indeed b2. So therefore, we can just write the system of equations as A times this X vector is equal to the B vector, right? The B vector is of length N, is of length M. The X vector is of length N, the N component. Okay? So over here, you have to solve the system of equations where A is a M by N matrix and B is a M length vector, okay? So what do? We define something called the augmented matrix, A tilde, which has A, and also the last column is B. The augmented matrix is just A and B. And now we're going to do Gaussian elimination just by considering the augmented matrix. Okay. So for the same system of equations, for the same system of equations, we're going to do the following. We're going to write the matrix A. We're going to write the column vector B. This is the augmented matrix A tilde. And now the pivoting operation over here is the same as doing a row operation. That is, in this case,
If we add this row to this row, that's the same as adding equation one to equation two, right?
Adding equation one to equation two is, I claim, the same as adding the first row of this augmented matrix to the second row of this augmented matrix. So, subtracting 20 times the first row from the last row is the same as subtracting 20 times the first equation from the last equation. So that's what we do. We do row 2 plus row 1 to get this equation, row 4 minus 20 times row 1 to get this last equation. So the same thing we were doing with equations, we can also do with matrices over here. Okay. And then we interchange. So interchanging rows is basically the same as interchanging rows of the matrix. Interchanging equations is the same as interchanging rows of the matrix. We pivot again, we eliminate again. So now over here, this 10 eliminates the 30, just like the x2 eliminates the x2 from here. So we end up with upper triangular matrix like this. Okay. So now we can then back substitute. The back substitution is just the same as before, and this is what's called Gaussian elimination. The basic advantage of Gaussian elimination is that it's systematic, works in general, works for large systems. We'll see many more properties about Gaussian elimination, but this example hopefully will clear something.